severed head on a pike seemed such a grisly trophy to be displayed in the chapel at Chalon. And yet it took me weeks before I got up the nerve to ask Father Armand why he kept it. The ancient priest stared out of the window for a long time, recalling days gone by. "I was there," he said finally, "at the Battle of the Catalonian Fields, fighting alongside Aetius and Theodoric the God. I knew there had been a battle here decades ago. Peasants still overturned skeletons and broken shields with their plows from time to time." "Who was it, Father?" I asked him. "Who are you fighting?" He turned back to regard me, paralyzing me with his old man stare. "Attila the Hun," he said. And then he told me the story. The Huns rode out from the wilderness sometime in the 370s, eager to feast on a Roman Empire weak from internal corruption and the expansion of other barbarian tribes. It was the Huns who drove many of these other barbarians before them. They were terrifying warriors from the steppes of Asia, their bodies disfigured from ritual scarring, their legs deformed from a near lifetime in the saddle. Despite their fearsome aspect, the Huns might have been little more than raiders had it not been for the leadership of Attila. He called himself the Scourge of God. Attila and his brother Bleda led the Huns not just to raid, but to devastate Scythia and Persia.
Challenge my every decision. It is as if you seek to lead the Huns yourself. Very well. The Iron Boar lairs near here. Let the one who kills this mighty beast lead our people. This way, Attila. Follow. Bleda will lead us to ruin. Perhaps he should not return from his boar hunt. Accidents can happen. Tracks, brother. See if you can ride ahead and flush the boar out.
Wood tree. Riding dash.
Attila, that boar would have killed me had you not intervened. Pity that none will ever learn of your loyalty.
Wood tree.
Archers, attack! Attila, fight and earn your right to rule.
It was an ambush. Bleda tried to kill Attila. Bleda is not fit to rule. Let us slay the rest of the traitors. Bleda is no more. When Attila returns to camp, he alone will rule the Huns. Attila is king of the Huns. He will lead us to victory against our blood enemies. Some time ago, the Romans captured a number of Hun villages. Bleda arranged for their return. I did not trust Bleda, and I do not trust the Romans. We should free them. No bargaining!
Тийм үү бол гоё бол гоё. Бэлэн байна.
Бодчин.
Гүүцтгий. Тийм үү.
Захир.
We raise this woman, come to the ground.
Шаал сонс.
Итлээ гүүцтгий.
Тийм. Гүүцтгий.
Итлээ гүүцтгий.
Тийм үү. Бэлэн. Итлээ гүүцтгий.
Захир. Барилгчин.
Тийм
үү, гүүцтгий.
Мэдлээ гүйцтгий. Тийм үү.
Мэдлээ гүйцтгий.
Гүйцтгий. Бэлэн.
Мэдлээ гүйцтгий.
Гүйцтгий. Мэдлээ гүйцтгий.
Бэлэн байна.
Тушаал сонс. Бэлэн. Тийм үү. Гүйцтгий. Мэдлээ гүйцтгий.
Гүйцтгий. үүцдэгэй.
Амар мэндүйтэ. Барилгачин, барилгачин. Барилгачин.
Captain
Solis
for
a
You must take them by force!
Timo, Freden, that's...
Son of Leopoxis, a leader among my people. If you free me, you will be rewarded.
We are saved.
Demo, Zacher.
My thanks for rescuing me. We nomads should work together. Perhaps if your leader, Attila, will visit our village in the west, our people can make an alliance. For now, a truce?
Sounds... 우츠트리
We owe the Huns more than our gratitude, but we desperately need 10 horses. If you could supply us with 10 horses, we will repay our debt of honor.
Шаар санс үүсгэе. Мэдлээ гүйцэтгэе. Тэ гүйцэтгэе.
Захир. Барилгашин. Амар мэндүү.
Барилгач.
захир бэлэн байна.
Тийм үү? Барилгач. Бэлэн байна. Модчин. Захир модчин. Амар мэндүү. Барилгачин.
Амар мэндүү. Барилгачин. Бэлэн байна. Тийм үү? Барилгачин. Захир. Барилгачин. Тийм үү? Модчин.
Бэлэн байна. Захир.
Амар мэндүү.
Тийм үү? Амар мэндүү байна. Захир. Модчин.
Тийм үү?
멋충 멋충 Бэлэн байна. Уурхачин, уурхачин. Уурхачин.
Захир уурхачин амар мэндүү Захир мотчин сургаал зүйл те. Тийм үү?
Бэлэн.
Мэдлэг үүсгэй.
Амар минь дүү.
Захир.
Захир. Бидэн байна. Барилгачин.
бэлэг чинь уур хаач.
Мотчин
амар мэндүү мотчин
захир амар мэндүү амар мэндүү
амар мэндүү уур хачин тимо би болгой мотчин захир уур хачин билэн байна барилгчин барилгчин уур хачин зүйтэй за амар мэмэй болгой тийм ээ болгой барилгчин барилгчин
үүсгэе.
Бидэн байна. Мод чин.
Ушаал сонс. Байлдаан бэлэн гүйцэтгэй. Бэлэн гүйцэтгэй.
Барилгачин уурхачин сойхи ди болгой зүтээ
Бэлэн
амар мэндүү үүдээ цахир би болгой барилгачин барилгачин мотчин сургаал сонс болгой за зүгээр амар байна уу
ийм тийм үү урагшаа давшаа ушаал сонс айлдаан тийм үү ушаал сонс бэлэн итгээ үүсгэн
бэлэн байна. Уур хач, уур хач. Уур хач.
Чао, сайн ба. Ичээ бүх юм уу? Гэ гүцтгий.
Амар минь дөө.
Бэлэн байна. Хэмо уур хачин. Захир уур хачин. Амар минь
засварчаа за.
Сонирхлын болгоомжтой зүйтэй.
Тушаал сонс мэдлээ гүйцэтгэе.
Тийм үү? Засварчин. Захир.
Сонс.
Амар минь дөө, засварчин. Барилгачин. Засварчин.
Тийм үү? За, за.
Тийм үү.
Амар мэнд үү? Би бол гоё.
Засварчин.
Бидэн байна. Захир. Барилгачин. Барилгачин. Уурхачин.
Тийм үү? Амар мэнд үү?
Захир.
Тийм үү?
Бэлэн байна.
Тийм ээ.
Бэлэн байна.
Захир, би болгоё.
Бэлэн, итлээ гүйцгий. Итлээ гүйцгий. Шаар сонсон. Айлдаанд.
Болгоосно. Тийм үү?
Тийм үү?
You play a dangerous game with the lives of your people by sending them into our territory.
Барилгачин.
You would be wise to withdraw from our domain and pursue your petty conquests elsewhere, Hans.
Барилгачин.
Шаар сонс, шаар, ашаар, тийм үү.
Итлээ гүйцгий.
харин
засварчин.
Shot.
I asked Father Armand more about this legendary Attila the Hun, whom the stories always treat as more of a monster than a man. He was a man, the priest said, But he did not look like the Romans, nor did he worship the Roman god. That was the cause of all that was to follow. Father Armand shivered as if from the cold breeze that blew in from the chapel's open windows. Kingship among the barbarians was not by divine right or lineage, but by who had the strongest will. Attila was the strongest of the Huns, and he reinforced his position by brandishing a rusty old blade and proclaiming it to be the sword of Mars, the old Roman god of war. Attila had a custom of fiercely rolling his eyes as if he wished to enjoy the terror that he inspired. He had a power over other men, so that many chose to join him. Many foreigners joined his council, Scythians and Burgundians and Goths. It was not uncommon for Romans to do so as well. Several decades prior, the son of a prominent Roman family had been sent to the Huns as a hostage to ensure peace. The name of this boy was Flavius Aetius, a name not soon to be forgotten.